Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making Campbell's Classic Green Bean Casserole. And most of you are familiar with that. Some of you may have grown up with it on the Thanksgiving table or the Christmas table. Some of you maybe need to be reminded of it or would like to be reminded of it and would perhaps want to put that on your Christmas table or Thanksgiving next year. I have done the updated version from Campbell's a couple years ago, and it has cheese in it and also red bell pepper. So it has a different look, a different taste. It's really neat, but it's not that good old-fashioned green bean casserole that most of you are used to. So I thought I'd go ahead and demonstrate that because I wanted to put it on my Christmas table too. So here's what we need to do the classic version. We need to take 2 cans of green beans that are cooked. So you can just get the canned green beans or you can cook them yourself. But the cans are 14½ ounces each, and you get a total of about 4 cups of these beans that are cooked and broken into pieces. This will not work very well if you get French sliced or if you use whole green beans. You need to have them snapped like this. Next, we add 1 can of mushroom soup. This is cream of mushroom soup, and it's just a normal 10.75 ounce can that you get soups in. And while I'm putting this in, I want to tell you that I am only doing half of the recipe. In case you see the recipe come up in a magazine or something, which at this time of year you will, if you read magazines very much, you'll notice that there's much more in the recipe because everything is doubled. But I will write up a consistent version, either the one I'm doing here or the one that's doubled. And if I do the smaller one and you want more, you can just double each one of the ingredients. So you get that in, and then you add 1/2 cup of milk. We'll be stirring all of this around in just a minute. Next comes soy sauce. And we have 1 teaspoon of soy sauce. And next we have just a dash of ground black pepper. It's a 1/8 teaspoon. And then this is the really special thing about this casserole. It's the crispy fried onions. I don't know what they were called here. Sometimes you see them as French fried onions, but they are crispy and you can see what they look like. This is a 3-ounce can and it's going to do my half perfectly. You need a 6-ounce can if you do the full recipe. But I take half of that, which turns out to be 2/3 of a cup, and put it in this casserole, reserving the other half, which is 2/3 of a cup, to put on the top when it's beginning to brown off at the end. So it's really an easy casserole to make, and it is so tasty, but the main thing it is that it is so traditional around this time of year that you usually, in the South at least, can't go anywhere for a big dinner without seeing this on the table. And I just didn't get around to it on the Thanksgiving table. It's probably more appropriate on the Thanksgiving table than it is on the Christmas table. But once this goes up, it will stay up for your future Thanksgivings if you have any interest in it. And it just needs to be mix together well enough that you can put it in the oven and let it start baking. So you want to separate those crispy fried onions out a little bit and get the milk and the soup together enough to blend in with the green beans. Now, this goes to a 350 degree oven and it's going to bake probably about a half hour. It might be less, 25 minutes. But before it's finished baking, I'm going to take the rest of the onions and sprinkle over the top. If you put them on now, they will probably get black or too dark and they will be too crispy. So we're going to wait toward the end and put that final touch on. Our green bean casserole has been cooking for 25 minutes. And what I want to do is get in here and stir it around. I haven't stirred it yet. It didn't really need to be. It's just if you do that continuously, the beans will just fall apart. So when it's toward the end, then try to get it mixed a little better than you probably could have done at the very beginning. So something like that. Now remember, it still has the crispy fried onions that I saved in this little container, and I just want to sprinkle them evenly over the top. And then we will leave this at 350 degrees, and we will let it just brown off on the top and then get it out of the oven. So you'll be able to see that in a minute. Here is our Campbell's Classic Green Bean Casserole. It just came out of the oven, so it's steaming hot. And I have my plate set up over here with my iced tea. And I'm just gonna scoop a little bit out of some corner here because this is going on my Christmas table. Just wanna show you the texture, and then we'll take a little taste of that. And I'll just hide what I took out right there. Very hot, so we'll take a little, and I want to get some of that crunchy top. I really like that the best, and then at least one green bean. So many of you out there know exactly the taste I'm tasting right now, and it is wonderful. You really can't go wrong with this recipe unless you hate green beans, because everything is designed to complement everything else, and the flavors just go together so well that it's very tasty. I highly recommend it.